A'udhu billahi minash shaitan rajim. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. O Allah, please protect us from Satan. In the name of Allah, most compassionate, most merciful. I remember when I first became Muslim, and when I read the Qur'an for the very first time, even though it made complete sense, I was amazed at Allah's reasoning. I was astonished. I was amazed at the unseen world and how Allah's commandments protects us from Shaitan. And that's why it's so important that we have a Quran in a language that we understand. We must understand it so that we can protect ourselves from Shaitan. Because this universe does not run on our human feelings. We as humans, we can feel a certain way about something, and we, in other words, our feelings are not necessarily the best guides. Our feelings and our emotions can lead us astray. That's why it's so important that we judge by what Allah has revealed. It's so important that we use a bookmark when reading the Quran, inshallah, so that we can pick up where we left off, so that we won't miss not one word of Allah's point of view. We won't skip over anything and say, oh, okay, I already read that. The Quran is not that kind of book where skipping is a good thing, because every time Allah repeats a point, He always throws something new into that particular verse. He always adds something new, or a new parable, or some other kind of explanation about something else. And I said all of that to segue into the topic, apostates. Now, when I first became a Muslim, I heard that if I apostated, I would be killed. Alhamdulillah, Allah guided me. Because that statement by itself made me afraid. It made me feel uncomfortable. It just didn't sit right with me that if I didn't obey, or if I didn't accept Islam, that I would be killed. That did not sit well with me. Alhamdulillah, Allah guided me, and alhamdulillah, I am a Muslim today. And please, Allah, please let me die a Muslim. Now, the issue with people who apostate, Allah has addressed it in the Quran. Yes, killing is involved, but it's not just an outright killing. Inshallah, I'll read in the English what Allah says. And I'm reading from Surah An-Nisaa. That's the fourth chapter. And I'm reading verses 88 through 90. What is the matter with you? Why are you divided into two groups concerning the hypocrites? While Allah has cast them off on account of their misdeeds, do you wish to guide those whom Allah has thrown out of the way? Whomever Allah has thrown out of the way, you cannot find a way for them to be guided. Their real wish is to see that you become a disbeliever, as they themselves have disbelieved, so that you may become exactly like them. So you should not take friends from their ranks unless they immigrate in the way of Allah. And if they do not, seize them and kill them wherever you find them, and do not take any of them as protectors or helpers. The exception is this, is for those who take refuge with your allies or come over to you because their hearts restrain them both from fighting against you and from fighting against their own people. If Allah had wanted, He would have given them power over you, and they might easily have fought against you. Therefore, if they leave you and stop their hostility and offer you peace, in that case, Allah has not granted you permission to fight against them. Sadaqallahu al-Azim, Allah has spoken the truth. This is another verse from Surah An-Nisaa that shows that Allah gives His creatures permission to worship Him or not, without killing them, as long as they don't fight against the Muslims. This is Surah An-Nisaa. This is the 4th chapter and the 137th ayah. Those who believe, then disbelieve, then believe again, and again disbelieve, and go on increasing in disbelief, Allah will not forgive them, nor will He guide them on the right way. This ayat about the apostates is from Surah Al-A'raf, the Heights. It's the 7th surah, verses 182 to 183. Those who reject our signs, we shall gradually visit with punishment in ways they do not realize, and I will give them time. Indeed, my plan is firm. Sadaqallahu alayhi. Allah has spoken it. This is Surah Al-Imran, the family of Imran. It's the 3rd surah and the 72nd ayat. And a group of the people of the scripture say to each other, believe in what was revealed to the believers at the beginning of the day and reject it at the end of the day, so that perhaps they will abandon their religion. Allah has spoken the truth. This ayat is from Surah Al-Imran, the family of Imran. Again, it's the 3rd chapter, the 118th ayat. O you who believe, do not take into your intimacy those outside of your ranks. They will not fail to corrupt you. They only desire your ruin. Hatred has already appeared from their mouths. What their hearts conceal is far worse. We have made plain to you the signs, if you have wisdom. Sadiq Allah, Allah spoke.